topic is Hardy and the Wessex novel. Thomas Hardy was born on 1840 at Higher Buckhampton, the fictional Casterbridge near Dorchester, England. He is an English novelist and a poet who set much of his works in Wessex, his name for the counties of southwestern England. His realism, prose style, characterization, and social criticism in his novels are the works of social commentary. He is best known for his novels, all of which were published in the mid to late 19th century. He began his literary career as a novelist by publishing Desperate Remedies in 1871. His last work, titled Test of D'Urbervilliers and The Jude of Obscure, made as the finest of his works. Hardy's poetry explores a fatalistic outlook against the rugged landscape of his native Dorset. He also rejected the Victorian belief in a benevolent God, and much of his poetry read as a sardonic lament on the bleakness of human condition. A traditionalist in technique, he nevertheless forged a highly original style combining rough-hewn rhythms and colloquial dictions with a variety of meters and stanzaic forms. He was much inspired with Romanticism and the poetry of William Wordsworth. He wrote 14 novels and 3 volumes of short stories and many poetries. He uses the word Wessex for the first time in his work titled Far From the Madding Crowd, and he was died on January 11, 1928. His funeral was on 16th January at Westminster Abbey, and it proved a controversial occasion because Hardy had wished for his body to be interred at Stinford in the same grave as his first wife Emma. So his body was buried in the Poet's Corner, Westminster Abbey, and his heart at Stinford with his first wife Emma. Moving on to the literary themes, as being a Victorian realist, Hardy examines the social constraints on the lives of those living in Victorian England. He criticizes beliefs on marriage, education, and religion. Hardy takes a stand against the rules of the society with a strong story of love that crosses the boundaries of classes. Fate or chance is another important theme. Far From the Madding Crowd is an example of a novel in which chance has a major role. He was the first novelist to explore man-woman relationship out of the marriage that causes a scandal in the Victorian age. His poetry explores the themes of rural life, nature, love and loss, cosmic indifference, ravages of time, and many more. Wessex is one of the kingdoms of Anglo-Saxon England. The name Wessex is an elision of the Old English form of West Saxon. It actually contains 6 counties: Berkshire, Hampshire, Wiltshire, Dorset, and Devon. Cornwall is adjacent and is referred to as Of Wessex. Knowing more about Hardy's Wessex, Hardy continually drew on the Dorset countryside, his family and neighbours in writing. Almost every scene or setting was based on personal experience, incidents of local life recollected and recounted by him, by his mother, or his own observation of nature and people around during this period. The partly real and partly dream country covered an area larger than that of the county of Dorset, and as Hardy suggests, was closer to ancient Wessex. This ancient Wessex contained all those 6 counties. He was unique in applying his own system of place names to the fictional area based in fact. He produces a map of Wessex complete with county boundaries, natural features, coastal resorts, and many more. Once created, the fictional name for a real place in one book was usually carried over to the other. The Weatherbury in Far From Madding Crowd appears throughout the Wessex novel as the name of Puddletown or Piddletown, as it was called before the reign of Queen Victoria. Dorchester, the heart of the Wessex, is referred to as Casterbridge in his works. Dorset's scenic coastlines features in many of his novels. Stonehenge remains as a monument and appears as a potent symbol in Test of D'Urbervilliers. Throughout picturesque, his scenes and his settings were not sentimentalized. Real hardship and poverty were too evident during the agriculture depression. Over the 21 years between the Desperate Remedies and the Jude of Obscure, he showed a growing pessimism. Hardy's later heroines and heroes shows individuals isolated from the rest of the society because they reject conventional pattern of behavior and belief. Hardy's Wessex novels are examples of naturalism, a branch of realism influenced by scientific observation. Wessex is like a petri dish in which Hardy explores what it is to be human. His stories had a recognizable territory. He both borrowed and invented names for the towns, villages, and countryside in which they were set. Thank you.